I'm Mike from Ebbs Coffee Roasters, and in this video we're going to be talking about barista speed. A fast barista is a good barista, but not while compromising coffee quality. So I'm going to go through five of my tips that I use for training to teach baristas how to be faster and have a better and more efficient workflow. Tip number one is to adjust the grinder while it is grinding, not stopped. There are two reasons for this. The first reason is that while the grinder is grinding, the grinding wheel is a lot smoother, giving you a lot more control over the adjustment being a lot more precise. If it is stopped, the grinding wheel is actually a lot stiffer and it's harder to get that precision. The second reason is workflow. It is faster to adjust it while it is grinding because you're able to purge and remove those shots that are on the old grind setting. But also while making coffee, the barista can sometimes see that the extraction is slowly starting to get a little bit faster or slower. And they can work this in with the grinding settings by just making small micro adjustments. And that gives you the ability to continue your workflow of making coffee without even having to purge or waste any shots. Tip number two, have a workspace that is correctly laid out and have robotic-like movements. This may seem very simple and very basic, but it is extremely important. An example here is having the correct cloths in the right locations and always replacing them exactly where they are. Again, with your milk jugs, milk bottles, any other accessories, your tamper. This helps your workflow and makes you a much more efficient barista, because having the tools at your hand and not having to find that cloth or find out where the tamper is, or having the tamper in the exact same location, makes you much more efficient and faster. The robotic-like movements help us get into a good rhythm and gives ourselves good habits of being able to do that thing over again in an efficient and fast manner. An example is, after purging the espresso machine, is to use that same cloth to wipe the drip tray. Is to put that tamper back into the same location after you've tamped and maybe smoothed off the surface exactly once or twice. Putting the trim milk jug back in the exact same location so you know exactly where it is. All these small measures help increase your efficiency and workflow. Tip number three is to purge the group head while removing the portafilter instead while inserting the portafilter. This may seem very simple and basic, but the amount of baristas I've seen who prepare the shot, do the dosing, tamp the portafilter, and they're ready to insert it into the machine, but they sit and stand there on the espresso machine and purge, waiting 2 to 3 seconds before entering it, is a complete waste of time. So you can set your espresso machine to have a purge button, and you can do this by programming the volumetrics in a particular button for 2 or 3 seconds of purging. And this allows you to press the button, allow the button to run for that 2 to 3 seconds, and then you don't have to press any button to stop it. So purging the espresso machine while you're removing the portafilter allows you to move on and start emptying the portafilter and clean it and move on to grinding rather than waiting at the espresso machine for it to purge. Tip number four is to group orders together according to the dockets. So the idea here is to look at all the dockets of the coffees that you're having to prepare and read them in advance rather than just one docket at a time. Doing this will allow you to group certain orders together. An example is if you've got soy milk on docket 1 and soy milk on docket number 3. Instead of doing 2 separate soy jugs, you can do 1 larger jug of soy for both of them. And this allows you to read ahead and group multiple orders in one. This tip does take practice and also does take a bit of hospo experience to be able to quickly read the dockets, understand them, absorb them, and being able to relay that onto the bar at the espresso machine. Tip number five, use efficiency measures depending on your setup. With a bonus on this one is steaming milk with no hands. So using efficiency measures depending on your setup, obviously depending on the type of equipment that you have behind the bar at work. An example is to create an efficiency and workflow with as little downtime as possible. Creating a workflow that fits within your equipment that you have. An example here is that our decaf, for example, that we single dose using the EK. So an efficiency measure here is to pre-weigh multiple decaf single doses before that we open and set. And this is going to increase our workflow by having these decaf pre-weighed single dose shots that we can go straight away rather than having to weigh them separately. Another example for us is we're using a gravimetric Mythos, and this grinder takes a long time to tear to zero, thus taking a long time to grind coffee. So once we've got the portafilter ready, we insert it into the machine. And instead of waiting there simply for it to grind coffee, we have to create some measures outside so we're busy and we're doing something to increase the workflow. So in our workflow here, while it's grinding coffee, we prepare our milk in our milk jugs. And by the time that we've got our milk ready to go, our portafilter has dosed and we're ready to tamp. Another example is with manual doser grinders, is that if you have a massive large coffee order coming up ahead, is to turn that grinder on and getting that doser relatively full so you're not sitting there manually dosing waiting for coffee grinds to come out. Another example is if you're using a two-group machine rather than a three-group machine, you may want to focus on doing a lot more shots before you steam that big jug of milk to increase your workflow, or squeezing in one more shot and having that extraction going while you're doing milk at the same time. So for this, you can just find out where there's a bit of a bottleneck or where there's a bit of a slow spot within your workflow and try create a measure that is going to help by filling your time with something productive while you're waiting for that particular device or extraction to do so. Now there's one last bonus tip that I want to share, and this is for the advanced barista. It's to steam milk with no hands. Look, Mum, no hands. So for this tip, it takes a bit of experience and lots and lots and lots of practice. And it is a little machine specific as well. Some machines don't give you the ability to do this because you've got no place to store and rest the milk jug. But have a bit of a play around with your machine and practice it multiple times because it does really help improve your speed and efficiency. So how do you steam with no hands, you may ask? Before you go hands-free or handless or with no hands, so before you remove your hands from the milk jug, you want to steam and aerate the milk to the degree of consistency and microfoam that you want for the coffee before you sit and rest the milk jug down. So start your milk steaming just like normal, create that microfoam, create that foam in the consistency that you want with the foam. Once you've achieved that certain level, which is generally 40 to 50% through the whole milk steaming process, you move the steam wand down and place the milk jug resting on the drip tray of the espresso machine, and you allow it to do its thing. After you remove your hands, you got free rein to create more shots, to prepare another jug of milk, and to move on. While it's steaming with no hands, you can almost hear or start to gauge a bit of a feeling of when it's reaching temperature. While it's steaming, I usually have one hand having a touch of the milk jug, just checking the temperature, and once you feel the temperature is right, you can turn the steam wand off. Just keep in mind that while doing this technique, you're going to need to move the steam wand in towards the espresso machine quite a bit, because having it too far out could potentially have an increased gap between the steam wand and the milk, creating an undesired amount of bubbles or microfoam. So the direction of the steam wand and the position is quite important, and this is just going to take a lot of practice and depend on the size of the milk jug and the volume of milk in the jug. So have a bit of a play around. While you're doing this, just remember to constantly hold the milk jug so that you know and understand the temperature that it's reaching, and practice this many times and have fun while doing so. So this concludes my 5 tips of becoming a faster and more efficient barista. If you're serious about improving your performance behind the bar, give these a go. Maybe just work on one tip at a time per shift, or one tip per week, and then move on to a next one. If you've got any other ideas, or if you'd like to share some of your own feedback, what has helped you become a better or a more efficient barista, I'd love to hear. If you disagree with any of my tips, I'd also love to hear your opinions as well. So thanks for watching, subscribe for some more content, and I'll see you soon.